So think about the last movie you watched. How did it make you feel? Like, what story was it trying to tell? When I am a movie buff, so I was brought up on movies like West Side Story, Wizard of Oz, Gone with the Wind, and it also broadened my horizon to the movies that, like, it broadened my horizon. It broadened my horizon to the great people and their stories. So my thesis today is movies play an important role in our society. It is there that stories come alive in front of our screen. Imagination soar, hearts beating, and our senses into attend. My main point is how movies can reflect our world, movies can inform and inspire, and do movies still matter? Movies can show a reflection of our world. It is important to pay attention to what the stories are saying. We are well into the 21st century, and the status quo dictates that we're not watching movies as much as we are watching television. And in that, it's taking screen time away. It's taken away from screen time. According to so we need to pay attention to what the movies are saying, and we need to pay attention to how movies are being seen and what they are. So, second point. movies can inform and inspire the next generation. So, Dr. Paul says, in an article, Dr. Paul says that movies can become the mechanism, great mechanism for conversation and reflection into one of the most accessible forms. It's one of the most accessible forms of art out there. People of all walks of life experience movies, from the working class to the super rich, and it provides a common experience for society to tell and talk about issues and talk about issues. Because they spurred comfortable and essential conversations. So I'm really excited about this movie. I'm gonna show you two clips.
Every kid has the right to play. That's why Toys R Us and Babies R Us promise to match any competitor's price. And each time we do, we'll donate an additional dollar to Toys for Tots, up to $1 million. The price match promise from Toys R Us and Babies R Us.
So, here it is. It's from the movie Oscar Schindler. Schindler's List. And Oscar Schindler is actually watching The Ghetto. Like the ghetto from the Holocaust being cleaned up, and he sees a little girl in the ghetto. Also is one of my other favorite movies, Dragon and Bruce Lee's Story. Lee, after his first performance, like first premiere back home in Hong Kong, he's just like waiting for the audience to react to him. Than older adults because they are still developing and shaping their worldviews. She said in that interview that since they are all still socialized politically, they're more likely to absorb all sorts of influences, including influence from family. So watching those clips, said that music can stand for story, imagination, and the synthesis of a variety of art forms. It beats obsolescence. So a final point, do movies still matter? Yes, they do, because because it can still inspire and influence and charge you to greater heights. And then you can still remember lines from that movie which impact and inspire a song. So a review of my main points, movie can reflect our world, movies can inform and inspire, and do movies still matter? Let's celebrate the art that film really is and be open to listen to what the stories they must tell and the conversations after, learning, growing, loving, leading.